Hi there, I'm going to introduce multiplication, addition, subtraction, and division using the multiplication tables that you have available in your doc sharing tab. Okay, I'm going to start with addition and subtraction. Okay, if you want to add two numbers like 7 and 8, you can do this one of two ways. In the addition table, what you'll do is you'll look at the row 7, go across that row, okay, and then the column 8, come on down until you see their intersection. That intersection is at 15, so therefore 7 plus 8 is 15. You can do this backwards if you prefer. Maybe you like to start with a column. Okay. Well, you can start with the column of 7 and then come over with the row of 8, and you still get the same answer. The commutative property of addition rocks that way. Okay, now let's go backwards and use our addition table for subtraction. Okay. So now what you want to do is you want to take 17 minus 9. Okay, this works very similarly to addition, just backwards. Okay, we want to subtract 9 from 17. So we're going to look at our 9 table, and we're going to go across until we see the number 17, which is right here. And then we come up from 17, and we see that our answer is 8. See, it's right there, right at the very top. That's how you use subtraction with your addition table. Okay. Now that we're done with addition and subtraction, let's go to multiplication. This is at the top. This is the first table of your addition and multiplication tables. Okay. We can take a number like 6 and multiply it to 7. Using the multiplication table, we do the same thing with the addition table. We start with the 6, come on across that row, and then the 7, come down on that column, and we find out that we get 42. You can also do this in reverse. You can start with the 6, for the column, come on down, and then you can come over from the 7, and you still get 42. Okay. Now the fun part of this is when you use this for division, because there's lots of ways you can use this. Okay. So you want to take the number 56 and divide it by 8. Okay, just like subtraction, you're going to come over on the row of 8, go across the row, and then you're going to come up from the number you're dealing with. So you've got the 56, you come straight up, and 7 is your answer. Okay. Now the coolest part about your multiplication table, it can help you with big numbers too. I don't know if you knew this. Let's say you want to take this big number, 31, and you want to divide it into 2,321. Now, holy moly, that doesn't seem like you can do that very well, but you can. You can use your multiplication table to estimate. We have our multiplication table. Now we don't have 31s and we don't have 2,321s in here, but we have 3 and 23. So what we can do is we can estimate. How many times does 3 go into 23 without going over? Well, we can look. here's our row three. We're going straight across until we get to as close to 23 without going over. That's 21. So the estimate, 31 into 232, is about 7 times. But I'm going to write it off to the side just to be on the safe side, because we don't want to go bigger. 1 times 7 is 7. 3 times 7 is 21. That's 217. 217 is less than 232, so we're in good shape. After we subtract, we get 151. We'll start this process all over again. About how many times does 3 go into 51? Well, we'll go down the same column. 3 into 15. 3 goes into 15 about 5 times. So I'm going to multiply 31 times 5, seeing if that's okay. 1 times 5 is 5. 3 times 5 is 15. Oops, that's too big. We can't put a 5 up here. So what we'll do is we'll do a 4 instead. 31 times 4 is 124. We subtract, and our remainder is 27. I hope this helps you use your math table. If you have any questions about this, please make sure to ask your instructor. They're going to help you quite a bit.